Hello, my name is Mevlana and I am the mobile applications product owner at Hepsiburada. After last year's UX Alive conference, one of the guys from UserSpots approached me and pointed a microphone to me and asked how was the conference, and I said it was great. And then he asked what was my expectations from the next UX Alive, and I said I expect to be on the stage, so here I am. So I will start with this graphic. This is actually pretty much most e-commerce companies in Turkey has been through in the last few years. I mean, a few years ago, mobile traffic was not that high, but we have been talking for like 10 years that mobile is becoming more and more important. Actually, before New Year, we always hear the same thing. I mean, this will be the mobile's year, and it's been going like for 10 years, but it actually happened around 2014 and 15. That's where the mobile traffic has surpassed the desktop traffic and become more prominent. So in these few years, we have been talking about the responsive sites, mobile-first approach, mobile mobile sites and native apps. But all of these conversations have one common topic. It's about conversion, because on mobile, at some certain categories like e-commerce, conversion is not at the level that we want it to be, because purchasing decisions can be hard, and people can have trouble deciding on certain kinds of products, deciding to purchase certain kinds of products, because they need more research, they need more data, and mobile simply does not help that. There are several issues. I mean, I just tried a few of them. Device fragmentation is one case. Connection issues, form factor, and browser capabilities are some of the reasons of that. And if we want to provide a better experience on mobile, then we should use more powerful platforms like native apps. Native apps can help us to get rid of some of the problems that we face on mobile. So the first strategy is use the power of the native apps more. The first step to use the power of native apps is actually deep linking. As you may all know, deep linking simply means sending a user with a URL directly to the directly to the page in that native app. We started implementing deep linking at Hepsiburada in the last year, and after the implementation, we have seen major increases in app traffic as well as app active users. So this is the first and the simple step. Right now, when you search at Google, for example, I search for LG G4, I see the search results, and then if I click to Hepsiburada search results, I see the splash screen of the app, and then I go specifically to LG G4 page in native app. This helps us convert better and to provide a better experience. The second step is actually related with deep linking. It's app indexing. App indexing simply opens your app's pages to Google so that it can be indexed on Google search results. This is what we implemented again. If I search for LG G4, in the search result, I see the Hepsiburada result with an app icon and the options to open them in the app or the mobile site. This helps us to get better CTR, since the app indexed results looks different from the other results, and it is more, with the icon and the different design, it appeals. It's more appealing. So actually this the next strategy is something more experimental. This is what Google wants to introduce. This is for apps with exclusive content on native apps. I mean, if you don't have a website and you have only app, then it is a closed system right now. But Google has plans to enable that content on the web without installing the app, and it's called app streaming. You can see an example here. If you search for hotel in Chicago, then you can see an app result, as you can see from the bottom. It is streamed by Google, and you don't have to install the app. This is, as I said before, this is something experimental, so I cannot show you any implementations. So before going further, I mean, this was the strategy one, use the power of the native apps more. And before going to the next strategy, I want to take you to 2005. It is 11 years ago. This is a blog post from 2005, and it is published on Adaptive Paths blog. And I mean, you can read it for a few seconds. It talks about how web interaction designers are envious of people who create desktop software. So the blog post tells us that, I mean, since desktop applications have a really rich experience, the website designer are kind of envious because they cannot provide the same level of experience that desktop applications provide. So this was actually possible. Sorry, I think skipped a slide. So actually, this is not the case anymore because of technologies like Ajax. Websites begin to provide a better experience on web. Like, I mean, this is something trivial for us, but once you click, for example, let's think about a like button on Facebook. Before Ajax, you had to reload the whole page again after any kind of interaction. So Ajax enabled us that asynchronous data retrieval, and this enabled websites to provide a better experience, and we, by that, we replaced some of the web desktop applications like Google Talk with web apps like Google Hangouts. So I again go back to the same blog post, and I will just replace the desktop applications with native apps. So it's 11 years ago, but if I just replace the desktop applications with native apps, the whole arguments are still valid. So strategy two could be create an app-like experience on the web. So that, I mean, you could provide a better experience, a richer experience, and you know, get more get better results. So we should have a first look at what's missing on websites right now. We can think of mobile websites specifically. We don't have home screen access on our mobile devices, and we are lacking engagement options like push notifications, or, I mean, even an icon on the home screen is something to be engaged for. We are lacking offline mode capabilities, we are having performance problems, and we are actually, we are not getting the best experience on mobile sites. Experience is comes with progressive web apps. The main features of progressive web apps are like, I mean, it works for every user. You don't have platform limitations. You have some browser limitations actually, but Chrome and Firefox supports it, and Safari has plans to support it. So it works everywhere. It fits any form factor. It doesn't matter if it's desktop, mobile, or whatever next. I will mention service workers later, but it provides an ability to work offline and ability to provide some content even of at low quality networks. It feels like an app, as I said before, and it is fresh because the service workers works like a cache mechanism. It shows you the cached content first, and then if anything new comes up, then it shows you the new content. It is safe because it's served via HTTPS, and it's discoverable. Search engines can find them. Re-engageable through push notifications and home screen access. Installable means, I mean, you don't have to install it from an app store, which is something that we don't want. But it is, I mean, you can add the shortcut on your home screen like an app. It's linkable. You can provide a link to share it. All of these actually features, most of those features, are possible because of service workers, and they provide us those features. Service worker is a script that is run by your browser, and it's separate from a web page. And since it is separate from the web page, it works independently from a web page. It can interact with the user even if your page is not opened. It works in the background, and for example, if caches needs to be updated, it can be updated even if the user does not launch your website. It enables push notifications. It can react to a particular time or date so that you can interact with the user, or it can respond to a geofence. Most of those items actually are the good sides of using native apps, but they are becoming possible with service workers on the web. The progressive web app experience is something that is fast loading. It can work on offline and on weak networks. It has smooth animations, scrolling, and navigation like an app. And it is engaging, and it is consistent across browser. As I said before, it is something still in progress, but that's the plan. So the overall strategy should become not to choose between native apps and mobile sites. For some products and for some sectors, you can choose one of those items, but for an e-commerce company like us, it's not reasonable to choose one of those paths, because in the past, for example, Flipkart actually closed their mobile sites, and it didn't end up well, so they had to build a new mobile site. So the strategy should be make more use of native apps through deep linking, app indexing, and app streaming, and then use new technologies on web to provide a better experience with progressive web apps. I think that should be the overall strategy, and this is the end of my presentation. If there is any question.
Hi, sorry, I'm not a developer, so I would like to understand more how you can make things work when it's offline, actually.
Yeah, I'm not a developer as well. So what's your question exactly?
I would like to understand more, like briefly maybe, about how you can make things still work when it's actually offline.
Yeah, it's actually a better caching mechanism. I mean, service workers are working in the middle between the web servers and the website. And if you have visited a certain page or a content, it is automatically cached it's cached automatically, so that when you are offline, you see the content that is cached. But the good thing is, when you are back online, service workers again work in the background to update those caches, so that you will be able to see the content, and then you will see the updated content. So it actually helps you to see a content, at least a content, even if you are offline. And then once you are online, you see the updated content again.
So we still have to trade off.
Sure.